When I was young, I wanted to learn the piano very much, but my family was too poor to learn the piano, so I remember drawing piano keys on white drawing paper to practice playing the piano. My sister loves to sing so much that she taught me to sing when I was too young to speak, and finally taught me to sing a two-part spin song when I was only 4 years old. When my sister became a college student and sang while playing the guitar, I, now only in middle school, was able to enjoy singing many pop songs in English that only college students sang. Since childhood, we have always been poor due to our father's continuous business failures, and we lived in a one-room house on the top of a mountain without a gate. But every evening, my sister and I talked a lot while looking at the moon and stars in the sky on top of the mountain that we could see right after opening the door, as if the whole mountain were ours. I constantly asked questions about what is the life, what kind of world exists outside the universe, and why I have to live with this hard life. My sister was talented at writing and always won prizes in writing contests in high school, and when the National High School Writing Contest was held at the university, she won first place. My sister being talented with writing, studying and singing, and later, she worked as a broadcasting station announcer because of her beautiful voice. Because of her, I was able to live with happiness, even though I was poor. Ever since I was in middle school, I felt sorry for my mother who was struggling to make money to live, so I wet my pillow with tears every night. In high school, when I went to school, I had to wear designated black shoes, but as I kept wearing one pair of shoes, the shoes were torn out. In season of winter, cold ice water seeped inside the shoes and my feet frozen, but I endured with those torn shoes and did not tell to mother to buy them new ones. If I told, she would definitely buy a new one, but I didn't want my mother to work hard to earn that money. I didn't ask to buy the designated school gym uniform, which all students should wear the same, but I just wore it with my sister's clothes of a similar color at home. It was tolerable during PE class, which takes place 3 times a week in class, but once a week, when all the students should gather on the playground, wearing designated gym clothes, and have a patriotic assembly, I felt myself like the ugly duckling inside, but I didn't ask my mother to buy it. At that time, I was thin due to lack of nutrition and had a poor appearance because I was short and poor, so I studied hard, not to be ignored by my friends and to give happiness to my mother. As a result, I always placed first or second in the class, but I cried when I placed second because my mother was very happy when I placed first, and it was the only gift I could give to my poor mother. Even when I had to go to college after graduating from high school, my father continued to be in debt because of his business failure, even though I was able to go to the best university at the time, but I entered the Seoul University of Education, which not only did not pay tuition with a full scholarship, but rather gave money to students once a year. The day I got accepted into college, my mother cried and said she felt sorry for me. Finally, after graduating from college, I worked as a teacher during the day and tutored at night to earn money to pay off my father's debts and to earn living expenses. Willingly, I gave all the money to my mother that I earned, but received the minimum amount of pocket money I had to spend. It took 7 years to pay off the debt, but I loved and felt so sorry for my mother that I silently carried the burden. When I was a teacher, I started to learn various musical instruments, but no matter how hard I tried, my skills did not improve, perhaps because I learned as I got older. Instruments such as the violin have been taught for more than 5 years, and tried cello, piano, and guitar, but all of them very hard to improve. Knowing from experience that musical instruments learning is easy at a young age, after marriage, I taught my children to play musical instruments from an early age. I taught my daughter piano and violin at home as a play from the age of 5. When she was 8 years old, she learned piano from a formal teacher and finished, and focused on the violin rather than the piano, and learned from a formal teacher at the age of 8. After that, my daughter's skills improved. She started learning from a music high school teacher. During the lesson, I recorded all the lesson sounds right next to her, wrote down the main points lesson in a notebook, and practiced it at home every day same as teacher lesson. After another few years, she played well, and we were very happy in a string ensemble together at church or at gatherings. I learned early on how to live by sublimating this exhausting and difficult life journey into various joys, singing sad songs when I want to cry because I am having a hard time in my life, and happy songs when I am very happy. Although we always lived in poverty, my sister and I harmonized a beautiful song every day and sang it as a duet, and then we were so happy, as if we were in heaven, and our souls were always in a dreamy and beautiful world. Then, at some point, I wanted to play with musical instrument, rather than a voice, but I missed the time because I was too poor to learn when I was young. I want my children to learn musical instruments when they are young so that they can easily play richly. So I spent money on children's lessons from a young age, no matter how difficult financially. The reason why I focused on instrument lessons when my children were young was because I wanted to give them emotional stability, develop their intelligence, and make their lives beautiful and enriched. It was because there was a desire to use it as a medium to open their hearts first by letting them hear beautiful melodies in the common language of music. Anyway, after that, we immigrated to the United States, and my daughter majored in biochemistry at UCLA, California State University, and completed the Doctor of Pharmacy course at Loma Linda University, and is working in California, USA. When my son was young, he learned various musical instruments, such as piano, violin, and cello. However, he didn't show any interests, so after my family immigration to the United States, I bought for him drum sets and gave him lessons from the professional teacher coming to my house, and then he was interested in drum lessons. He studied in Africa and India while attending a San Diego University of USA. After graduation, got a master's degree at Riverside and Pepperdine University, and then received PhD major in behavioral analysis with a full scholarship to cover tuition and living expenses at South Florida University. Currently, he is working at Johns Hopkins School of Medicine USA, focused on behavior analytic assessment and treatment. My husband and I made a retirement plan a little early for our future, because my parents were so financially difficult that I couldn't pursue my dream in my youth. I sent money to my parents for the living expense every month for almost 25 years, and after my mother got a stroke, I took my father and mother to the United States and took care of them with my sister until they passed away. When my family immigrated to the United States, we worked day and night. It was financially difficult to live with my children, but also I had to take care of my parents too. So I made a retirement plan in advance because I didn't want to give my children this heavy burden. Even though our retirement pension is not a large amount, we want to live in missionary work as long as our health permits. We searched for a country where we could live with just the pension we received, and a country where we could simply settle down, and in the end, God guided us to the place where we live now, and we moved there. This is a natural ecosystem protection area with clean air and abundant agriculture, livestock, and fish where we can live comfortably with small money, so it felt suitable for us to live quietly and praying. In the USA we weren't wealthy, but we lived a simple life, enjoying concerts and family trips, traveling and singing with children. All the happy things feel like yesterday. My son and daughter say they love to live in USA, but I'm sick and tired of living in USA where I have to earn money for the rest of my life. Even now, we can talk with our daughter and son living in the United States every day via the internet, and occasionally meet and travel, but now this rural village in Argentina is as peaceful as if it were opened with the arms of a mother. But I still have a dream to make it come true. There is a regret that I couldn't learn the instrument I wanted to learn so much when I was young because I didn't have money. Now, my remaining hope is to approach the poor and needy children through the medium of music to give them happiness, and to preach the gospel. I am praying that someday, when the time comes, I will be able to set up a small music school for the children here. Even though I am so small and shabby, isn't our God the one who made the whole universe? Even now, I do not let go off the thread of hope here, and I sincerely pray to God that this dream will come true. Away from the noise of cars, fumes, and bustle of the city, listening to the little stars pouring every night, the chirping of insects, and the singing of birds, I pray here for the world, and give thanks to my Lord every day.